Hi there, and thanks for joining us here on the web. Nearly 5 inches of rain fell in some parts of northern New Hampshire overnight, creating dangerous flash floods. Several homes had to be evacuated and roads were washed out in Coos and Grafton counties, prompting the opening of the State Emergency Operations Center. Adam Harding reports.
I was not going to be able to go too far, that's for sure.
It almost looks like a pond, but this is Patricia Bilodeau's driveway, now completely washed out after an early morning storm.
I went right straight to the kitchen door, and I looked down my basement. I put the light on. I went, oh, my God, my basement's getting flooded.
And most of that water is still there, almost 10 hours later.
The upstairs is fine. It's the basement. My freezers are upside down. My washer and dryer's upside down. They said the furnace is gone, so everything in the basement's going to have to be pulled out.
Even Patricia's car might be a total loss. That's because there's so much water blocking her garage door, she couldn't get it out in time. Firefighters spent the morning pumping out as much water as they could on Dells Road. But this is just one spot in town that got hit hard.
We had major washouts on Mount Misery Road and Broomstick Hill Road, and some minor washouts of ditches and culverts throughout the rest of the town.
And with more rain in the forecast, many here are just thankful last night's storm wasn't any worse.
You ever seen anything like this?
Never. Not like this.
The situation is even worse just to our west. Environmental officials in Vermont say floodwaters have overwhelmed the sewage treatment plant in Montpelier, and raw sewage is flowing into the Winooski River. About 200 people were forced from their homes in Barrie because of flash floods. One house even collapsed. And schools in several towns across central parts of the Green Mountain State are closed, roads washed out. Some are even covered by mudslides. And utility officials say at the height of this storm, more than 10,000 customers were without their power. Rochester police are looking for a man they say robbed the Shell station on Milton Road early this morning. Investigators say a man with a gun and a bandana covering his face entered the store and demanded money. You can see him in this photo. He got some cash from the register, grabbed some cigarettes, and took off. If you have information, call the Rochester Crime Line at 335-6500. Well, you may be packing up now to head somewhere for the weekend or cleaning the house to get ready for visitors. 540,000 people are expected to flock to New Hampshire from out of state this Memorial Day weekend. And Ray Brewer reports.
Of the more than 500,000 visitors expected to come to New Hampshire for the holiday weekend, New Hampshire Department of Travel and Tourism says that many of those will come from Canada, New York, and other parts of New England.
Phil Bucari is one of them, taking a break to check his boats before continuing up north.
My cousin has some property up in Lincoln, New Hampshire, and we're going fishing. We're going to catch some trout. We try and do it most every Memorial Day weekend.
Many of those visitors are expected to head to the beach. Tom Pierce, who was working at Hampton Beach doing heavy construction before leaving on his vacation, says he's noticed the influx.
In the last couple days, a lot of people are starting to show up, and, you know, 3 weeks ago, there was a ghost town. Now, people are coming around.
One thing that could impact travel, higher gas prices. When this car was new back in 1930, gas was about 10 cents a gallon. Now, according to AAA, the average price in New Hampshire is $3.84 a gallon. A year ago, it was $2.76. Valentine Foss thinks that is keeping people home.
I see a lot of people that just aren't doing any traveling that they normally would do for Memorial Day, probably right through the summer.
But not the woods. Although they only get about 10 miles to the gallon towing their camper, they wouldn't think of staying home.
It's like a mini vacation. We get away for the weekend. This one's a long one. We both work hard and like to enjoy the time.
And Ray Wood says after watching the camper sit all winter, now that the nice weather is here, he can't wait to hit the road and actually enjoys the driving.
The truck loves pulling the trailer. It just feels like a truck. You know, it's not bouncing around so much though when it's empty. It's a great experience.
The visitors are expected to spend some $85 million over the holiday weekend.
Despite the economy, that's up about 3% from a year ago. In Hooksett, Ray Brewer, WMUR News 9.
An autopsy is scheduled for today on a body found in the Connecticut River. According to Fish and Game, an EMT out canoeing with some kids from a nearby school discovered the body yesterday. Authorities say they're investigating the possibility that the body is that of 36-year-old Joshua Parrott, from North Walpole, who's been missing since April. Well, starting tonight at 5 o'clock, nearly a dozen Derry residents out of their homes this afternoon after a car struck their apartment building. The crash happened this morning on Route 102. Residents are now forced to leave over safety concerns, and tonight, what may have caused this crash and if the driver will face any charges. That does it for this webcast. Thanks for joining us, and have a wonderful holiday weekend.